All right, so we're back and continuing the run through our dungeon here in Adventure 7, Final Insult. We're still locked in I wouldn't say locked in the first part of the chamber, but it did take us several turns to get through there. I believe 5 turns, and this is still where we're at. We still got to make it to the second one here, and which we've already opened the door for, so that's a good part. And then our third and final chamber here, which is going to have the boss in it that we need to fight. So hopefully we can get through this with as much efficiency as possible, because I only have 7 turns to get this done in before the Overlord has claimed victory on me, just due to the timer. So let's move right into it. I want to get my two fighters into the fight as quickly as possible and get them in the front line so that they're protecting my weaker wizard and archer. So first one I'm going to have go is Rorden. I'm going to have him move. He has a total movement of 6. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to put his arc facing the front here, so all five of those spaces will be his front arc. And he's going to attack that archer skeleton right there. So this is what we're going to do. First play. He is going to get his 5 dice for the attack. And the skeleton archer gets 2. And I don't think there's anything Rorden can give that's going to help out, but yeah. All right, so for the archers, we're ignoring anything with an armor of 1, so ones will be ignored. I have nothing else to help me there, so this one's taken out. So he rolled a 5, a 4, a 3, and a 2. The archer rolled a 6, which cancels out my 5, but 3 of my hits did get in, and that is enough to completely destroy and remove the model. So that turn is done. So we're going to see if we have an interrupt. We have a 3 interrupt. Holy crap. For this one. So we got 3 models that are going to activate, and they're looking for the spellcaster, but there's none of them that are in range, even remotely close to being in range to doing anything, except maybe for the archer here. So we might try to take him first to see if he can go get the spellcaster. He'll need a long range, which anything here. He can't shoot from this space, I don't think, because, let's see. Oh, he can shoot from this space, and he can shoot from this one. But the minimum needed, I just need to move him the minimum amount needed in order to get the attack. So he'll move to this space, and which is enough in long range to do that. So he will get 3 shooting dice, and I will get just 2 to defend with. My armor is nothing special, it's a 1. So this might hurt a little. Yep. Well, no, maybe not, maybe not. Oh yeah, I did. Okay, so he rolled a 6 and a 5 and a 2. I did okay by rolling a 6 and a 5, but one hit still came in, so I'm down to 2 more hits on this guy before he is down. So that is not good. I need to really do something about that immediately. Probably hand off a healing potion to him. Maybe when Orloff runs by him, he can hand him a healing potion to help out. All right, so we still have 2 models left. So this one's activated. This one can't move up to get him. So the only other options that we have is try to bring these two guys up into the fight to help out a little bit. So that's probably what we're going to do with our last 2 activations. We'll bring them as far as they can go, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. And this one, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then this one, oh, that was okay. So that was 2 models that just activated. And then this is the archer that went. So everybody's kind of starting to pile in this way to take out the threats. All right, next I want to move with Orloff, or do I? I'm not quite sure on this one yet. Orlov does have one left feet, but it's not going to help because, yeah, it's not going to quite help yet. And they put me in a pickle because if I move up here, I'm in the front arc of more than one enemy, which kind of stinks. All right. I might opt to go ahead and move my wizard. I'm going to move him 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to move him right here next to Rorden. And then we're going to see what might be a good idea to cast off. Can't do any feats because I moved. I only have power one energy crystals, so I'd probably have to do two major spells. Flame Bolt. No, I want to do something that's really going to make it to where I can get rid of those guys. Burn is a major spell. Steel Skin. I haven't used that one yet. I guess I don't have but just a couple of majors. Everything else I own is a minor. Crystallize, Flame Bolt, minor. Okay, so the target rolls +3 dice up to a maximum of 6 in defense against every attack until the end of the round. I'm going to roll that and give that to myself just because I'm not doing too well. Alright, so burn is going to be a 4 dice magical attack. I will go ahead and use one of my power 1. So that's going to make it a 5 attack. I think I'm just going to try to put that on. If I try to go for the Revenant, I might not do too well because he's got 4 combat dice, so I might try to put that just on one of the regular skeleton warriors. So we'll do that. I'll do two on the skeleton warriors, and it'd be this one right here in the middle is who I'm targeting. All right, so we roll my 5 dice and we ignore any 1s and 2s. Okay, so this is out. So we rolled a 4. 4 and a 4. Oh man, 2 6s, so I only got 1 hit in. I'm pretty sure that was a 1 and 2. I have serious trouble messing up those dies when I pick them up. Hold on just a minute. Okay, so it was a 2 and a 3. Only the 2 was a feeble attack, so 2 of my hits came in, and that's as such, it will turn this into a bone pile. So that got really lucky. I need to start paying more attention to that. And so burn has been used up, so that will be put down at 180 degrees, and then steel skin, target, so we'll go ahead and add that to myself. Caster, just because he needs some defense coming in. He might be in a pickle. Alright, so steel skin has been used. And that's until the end of the round. Just gotta remember that. Next turn. So we have 1 interrupt. And this is for the spellcaster. Thank God I gave him the steel skin. So we got some choices here. The Revenant, the skeleton warrior, or the archer can attack. The ranger's got line of sight. The archers, if it were me picking the targets right now, I would probably go with the Revenant just because that one has the most likelihood of doing damage. So we'll move the Revenant up to attack the spellcaster. The Revenant's going to get only 3 dice because he is outnumbered. He's standing in the front arc of two heroes, trying to say that right. Alright, because of steel skin and I put that on me, I roll +3 dice and in defense against every attack. So 3 dice, and then he gets his normal 2, so he's getting a total of 5, and that is what we're going to roll. And then my armor is 1, so the Revenant's only going to be ignoring 1s. Okay, still did good. Still did dang good. Doesn't matter, I couldn't block all the hits, so 1 came in. Man, he might actually just kill me outright instead of a... Instead of running out of time, I just might lose my life. And the Overlord only needs to score 1 more hit. And this round will be done. Okay. That was the 1 interrupt. So we can move back into our regular round. Let's see. Where to go? I'd like to take out that... Revenant very quickly, or we're going to have some trouble. So Orloff is going to move his 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I am going to be facing... Actually, my arc is going to be facing this way here. And I'm going to attack the Revenant. Now, my attack is going to get 5. Revenant has... usually with 4, however he's outnumbered, so that's 1 away, and he is getting attacked from the rear completely, so that's 2 away, and his armor is 3, so we ignore any 1s, 2s, or 3s, so that one is feeble. I did roll 3 6s and a 5, he rolled 2 1s, so that means he's dead and off the board. Okay, that was the end of Orloff's turn, and... There is no interrupt, so we move on. The only one left to act will be our archer. So he's going to move. He has a total movement of 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And he is going to try to hit that archer right there in the back. She should be fine. He's got a dice roll of 5. And... The skeleton archer has 2. The archer has an armor of 1. Okay. So we take that away. However, I do have sure shot 2, so I can re-roll that one. Oh, that's better. 6, 4, 4, 4, 3, rolled a 5 and a 2. All the hits came in, so this one's gone. Okay. And that finishes the hero's turn out, so we're going to flip over. We have 2 cards here, but we all know what's going to happen. We're going to have activations for 2 things that are on the board, and that's going to be this bone pile and this skeleton here. Now, the first one to go would have been our card here for the marksman. So he's got good target for the marksman, so he's going to go 1, 2. He's going to attack the marksman. He has 2 dice. He can't get any lower than that. No, I'm sorry. He's not going to do that. He's going to go back to where he was. He's shooting. I don't know why I moved him. Shooting dice are 3. My archer is a combat dice of 3. And he does have a +1 armor, so we need to remember that. So 3 dice. And my armor is 2 +1, so he'll ignore any 1s, 2s, or 3s. So this one's feeble. 6 and a 5 and a 5. He got a 5 and a 4, so no hits came in. And that finishes the activation on hand. The only activations left is to raise a bone pile. So we're going to see what we get. Or using my normal formula, it's going to be a archer, I believe. Yeah, skeleton archer. So that one's raised up. And because that's the only choice we had, he is going to get a free strike from Orloff. Orloff is getting his 5 dice attack. The archer gets 2. And we ignore any 1s. Oops. Yeah. Any 1s. Okay. So all the hits did come in. 5, 2, 5, 3, 2, 2, and 2. So 5 and a 4. He blocked this one. And this one, however, 3 hits still came in, so he's gone again. And that completely finishes out the Overlord's turn. There's no other models that can activate on here because everything has been activated. So that finishes out this round. And we burn the next Overlord card. We take off this marker since the round is over. The two people that get to roll on their wounds is Orlov, first one. Got a three. Now Rorden. Got a three. All right. So now we're back again, starting, and Denor is in a serious bind right now. He cannot take any more hits. I mean, he has no way to heal either. Okay. First, what we're going to do is Orlov is going to activate. He's going to move one here to right behind Orlov. He's going to hand him off the healing potion and then continue hit on. That was one, two, three, four. And he's going to attack the skeleton from behind. It doesn't really matter, but five dice for Orlov, two dice for the skeleton warrior, and I guess, yeah, we can take his armor down by one, so we're ignoring any ones that I roll. Okay, two feebles with Orlov's frenzy. He can re-roll two dice that fail to attack. Okay, so now we have two sixes, a five, and a three. He rolled a six and a four. Only one was beat, so three came in and killed that one all the way out. That finishes Orlov's turn. This will be a next card that we burn, but there's nothing on the board, so we can't do anything. So we're just going to continue to move up. Yeah, there's not a whole lot of decision to do here. I will go ahead and activate. Let's see how far my Denor can get. He can get seven. I'll move him. Do I want to cast anything off anybody? Let me see what I want to. Oh, I forgot to refresh those up 90 degrees from last turn, so those are still there. I do have miners available to me. The first thing I will do is use my healing potion. Take off one of these wounds. Feel like I'm doing a little better. Break Ward is one I know I'm going to want to use this round. I might want to use Brisk Work on somebody. I'm not using Flame Bolt. I definitely want to use Crystallize. Don't need to use that. Shield is probably one that I'd... Okay, so I think I have my four here. Shield... Shield I'll use on myself. So we'll put that here. And we'll give myself a counter to remind myself. We'll use Crystallize. See what I can get. Please let it be something powerful. Dang it. Nope, it's a power one. Okay, now we want to do Brisk Work. Oh, you know what? I totally forgot to move myself. I'm totally going out of order here. What I wanted to do first was my movement. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I think that was his total, right? Yeah, 7. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wish I could have gotten a little further to do Break Ward. Let's see. I was here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Well, I thought I was going to use Brisk Work on... okay. Sorry about that little break. I had to run somewhere real quick. Alright, so I was just finishing out the turn for Denor. The last thing we did, I think we put shield on, we crystallized, didn't get anything good. Then I was going to do Brisk Work. I was going to cast Brisk Work on myself. And we're going to move two spaces. So I'm going to put myself down here. I'm only going to go one, that's all I need. I'll put myself out facing this direction. And this is kind of a backup, just in case we have some trouble with the door here. I want to go ahead and start the process of whittling this one down. So we'll go ahead and do Break Ward, and we'll turn that into a ward of one. And that's going to finish out the Norse turn all the way. So we flip our next card. It doesn't, like I said, doesn't matter, but we have to do it just for the card numbers. And then we move on to our next one. So we've had, we still have, I think everybody needs to go. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Orloff was first. He killed the skeleton. Then we had Denor go. So we still have Rorden and our archer. Now, Rorden's not going to be able to make it. He's only got a movement of 6, I think. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, he won't be able to make it. So looks like what we're going to do is probably next turn, I'm just going to have the wizard pop the door open and bring us into this room, which is going to feed us. So we'll try to get down as far as we can go. So we will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is as far as I can get him. And then we'll see. We don't have an interrupt. And then we're going to go 8 movement here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I'm going to leave myself right there. There's really nothing else I can do. And then we move into the Overlord turn, which there is nothing the Overlord can do. So we burn the next card. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 turns. So basically the turn that I get in and pop this door, we got to come in and start really hammering down the king here, because 5 turns might seem like a little bit, but it is not that much time, especially when dealing with those two things that are pain in the butt. Not being able to be attacked by spells or arrows. So yeah, we're gonna have a little bit of a fun time with this one. Okay, so we did the Overlord turn. We burned the Overlord card. The spells can get refreshed here, and the last thing to do would be roll on our tough abilities. Okay, so that was 2 for Orloff. That was nothing, and Rorden. 2 for Rorden. Man, I'm rolling the same. Why can't I be rolling 6s? Ridiculous. All right, so for this one, I definitely know Denor needs to stay out of sight. This is can't be any more important, because 2 hits, he's gone. He's done. Lucky for me, Gruun does not have any ranged abilities, so that is a plus. But that means we got to get the 2 range or 2 warrior characters up into the fight. Absolutely. So, let's see. We know we want Denor to pop the door open. So she's going to be, or he's going to be doing break ward. May do brisk work. We'll see about that. Do want to do crystallize, and shield has already been cast. We could cast steel skin, but that is a... That is a, you know what, I actually could here, I could go ahead and, is that going to be corrode? Let's see, this amulet, the wearer cannot suffer a wound because of shooting or spells. Okay, so I could cast corrode on him. Minor, but I would have to open up that door first, and I don't see anything else here. Steel skin is a major. Okay. So I think these are the 4 that I'm going to go with. I'm going to go with corrode, or can I do 5 minors? Let's see. Cast 3 turns. 3. Okay, no, I could do 4 total. All right. So the first one I'm going to do is break ward. We're going to go ahead and get that one out of the way. Which is going to take this door out of the map, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to roll crystallize and see if I can put anything good in my bag. I want to roll a blue one. Okay, we've got a 4. That's going to give us a power 2, so we're getting somewhere. Now, this is only going to help me for fighting against other creatures, like anything that's going to pop up here. It won't help me for fighting him. Corrode is a short range spell, so shit, that means I can't launch that one off. I don't have enough range. I didn't even, okay, well, never mind. And brisk work, maybe brisk work. Where would I have to be? God, I wouldn't even be able to make that one. Brisk work, I'm gonna cast that one on. It's a short, but I do need line of sight. My line of sight is being. Do I have line of sight? I don't have line of sight on him. The only one I'd be able to give that one to is him. So we'll move him up one, two. So we're gonna put him right there in front of us. So that was brisk work. And that's it for Zenor's turn. And then we flip our next card. We don't have an interrupt, thank goodness. So now we need to decide who we want to get up into the fight. Definitely needs to be our Rorden. Although, man, he's running pretty low here on wounds. But we got to do this. We got to get up there and fight. So we will go. Let's see. He can move six. One, two, three, four. No, I don't want to do that. One, two, three, four, five, six. I won't be able to stay on a bone pile. Dang it. Okay. Well, needless to say, that is as far as I really want to bring him because that way he can possibly be able to do something. So, it's not great. Not great circumstances. Okay, so now, flip our next card. No interrupt. So we can move Orloff in. He's going to go. I think he's got, what is his? Seven. Okay, so one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Not as far, but close. Nothing else he can do. So we flip our next card. No interrupt. Last one to go is going to be our Ranger. So we're going to go one, two, three. I'm definitely going to get him out of the way. And that's it. So now the fun part. We're gonna have some baddies to raise, and then our king dude here to start attacking. I'm gonna look up my rules real quick on furniture. I don't think I've actually had to deal with that just quite yet. So let me go look that up, make sure I got that down, and then we'll continue the turn here. Okay, yeah, so there are some rules looking at the furniture. If it's not a bookcase, then it's not going to block line of sight. However, it will block movement, so I won't be able to move through those two spaces there. Now, another thing for shooting attacks, specifically for archers, is that if I'm shooting anything that is basically over here, then if I'm not adjacent to the actual piece of furniture, then I take a negative one dice on any hit. So that would be anything back here. So I kind of got to take that into account and keep that in the back of my head. So if it's up here, it's not going to matter, but anything back here, it is. So, but I can't be doing any shooting attacks to him anyway, so it's kind of pointless on that regard. But as far as the menus are going to pop up, yeah. Okay, so first on the Overlord turn. Is we're going to be activating our four models per the instructions. And they're going for Marksman or Quest. Now, obviously, Grund, he can only have a movement of four, so he's not going to be able to make it up to the Archer, nor would he try to go for Rorden because he's not going to stand on one of his own bone piles and prevent that from going up there. Nor would he also. Block any of the path that's going to try to go through for these guys. I know it seems kind of a bit, what's the big thing going to happen here is raising some bone piles. So first thing I'm going to start is probably go ahead and do the four activations back here and get these raised up so we can see what we're dealing with. All right, so first we're going to have on the board is going to be a Dwarf Revenant. I hate those guys. All right, so we have our two quadrants here. I'm going to do one, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, so it's going to be on this side. This is going to be one, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, so it's going to be right here, Revenant. Okay, next one is, looks like it's a archer. Okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so it's gonna be over here. 1, 2, 3, top, 4, 5, 6, bottom. Okay, 6 is gonna be bottom right there. It's actually not a bad place for the archer to be. Next is one of those two. Looks like it's a one, so it's gonna be a warrior. Where's my warriors? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so it's right here. And then we already know what we have next. Is, let me see, I can have a max of two revenants on the board, and it looks like it is going to be another revenant. This is going to be crazy, guys. So freaking crazy. All right, so that was our four activations for this card. And this one is going to be one, and it's going after the marksman and the weakest. Now, none of these four can act. Don't think he's going to do anything, so we're probably going to activate this one right here because that one won't get any free strikes. So let's go ahead and roll. Okay, it's a five. We can't roll any revenants because we already have our max two on the board. So 1, 2, and 3 would have been a warrior. 4, 5, 6 would have been an archer. So we're going to go ahead and put the archer on. All right, where that was. And that's pretty much going to complete everybody's turnout. There's nothing else that the Overlord can do because everybody's had their activations. And then we finish the turnout by sacrificing yet another card. And then I'm trying to think here. We roll. Oh, these are going to go ahead and refresh all of my miners that we used. So everything should be available to me. And then we roll on our heels, Orlov. Ooh, we got a six, finally. All right, Rorden. Got a three. All right. Oh, four turns, guys. That's all I have to get this done in. That is it. Now remember, no shooting spells can be done against the Grund, nor can any spells be done on him via the amulet. The wearer cannot suffer a wound because of shooting or spells. Now, that doesn't mean that he can't be targeted by spells. Things like, let's see, Feet of Stone would be one that is good. It's a long, but it is a major spell. Another one that we could use is Corrode on him. That would be a nice one. We could also use Steel Skin on somebody. All right. So those are all short. So I might just do these two if I want to cast off two spells. No line of sight, but the Corrode is a short range, which means he would have to be. Oh man, he would have to be right up in the fight. Ugh, don't like that. Okay, Feet of Stone means he would have to come up just one more in order to get that off because he doesn't need line of sight, he just needs the range. All right, so first movement is going to be here. So we're good on range. He's going to cast Feet of Stone, which is his first major. Target is unable to move for the remainder of the round, and they attack and defend at negative one dice. So we'll move that one upside down. And we will note that Mr. Grund has Feet of Stone and he is locked down. We will also, I guess we can't do Corrode. So if I can do two majors, two minors equal a major, so I might do that. I know it seems a little out of the rules, however, it's really not stated in the rules that it can't be done. I could do a minor. I know I don't need any more break wards, so I'm going to put that one off to the side. Crystallize might be a good one to use. Briskwork is a minor. Or I could use. Lots of choices here. All right, I know I want to use Crystallize. Let's see what we got. Kind of power one. don't need any more freaking power one energy crystals. Okay, let's crystallize. And so that was my one. So I could do in one more miner. And I could use, I could do flame bolt with a power two energy crystal. This is a long range, does require line of sight. I don't have line of sight on anybody but this guy here, fortunately. So, two dice magical, or four dice magical attack because of the power energy crystal. Flame bolt is a minor. The archer that I am targeting will get two dice, and he has an armor of one. So hopefully this works. wow. No, it did not. So he only got one hit in. And for an archer, one hit has no effect. Man, that was a nice roll for the archer. That finishes my turn out. And then we see if we have an interrupt. We do not. Next will be... next will be maybe the archer, just to try to see if we can whittle down a target here. Because until we do that, Orloff's not going to be able to make it in to do any attacks. So, I'm going to go ahead and run the attack from the archer to this other archer here. My guy gets five dice, the archer gets two, the archer has one armor. And we can reroll these two feebles. Okay, better. So I got two fours, three threes. He blocked one of my hits. Four came in, so this one's dead. That is all the archer can do. And then we see if we interrupt. We do not have an interrupt. We move forward now. Man, I really need to try to get in there and throw some hits on that guy. Really do. Okay. I will go ahead and move Rorden up 1, 2. Or do I want to move him here? I guess it doesn't really matter. I'm going to be in the front arc of multiple enemies no matter what I do. Okay, I'll leave him here. And I will go ahead and attack the king. Okay, let's see if we can do all this math here. So we have normal five dice. He is attacking... or he is outnumbered by two enemies, so he gets one less die. However, I'm going to use a battle potion, which is plus two dice to the next fight attack. So he's going to get a total of six. I'm attacking the king, and he normally gets five combat dice. What a brute. But he is attacking and defending. Let me make sure this is right. He is attacking... and defending at negative one dice. So instead of five dice, he'll only be defending at four. He does not have any less on his armor, but his armor is four. So we'll see if I can make a good attack here. Oh my god. What the heck? That was... nasty. Nothing came through. I got one hit, but he blocked it with a six. What a turd. Alright. Well, yeah, that did nothing. So, now we see if we interrupt. We do not interrupt. Okay. That was kind of lame. I wish I could have done better. Well, I think Orloff is my last one to go. So he'll move 1, 2, 3, 4. He's going to move and try to attack the Revenant here in front. He is going to get 5 dice for his attack. The Revenant gets 4. 5. And the Revenant has 3 armor. So we ignore 3s, but I do have my reroll ability, so hopefully this ends in my favor. Alright, so we had 3 feeble rolls, so I'm going to reroll 2 of those. So hopefully I can do better. A little bit. Okay, so 3 5s. He rolled a 5, and so 2 of my hits came in. If 2 hits come in on a Revenant, it's replaced with a bone counter. So, not bad, not bad. Okay. All right, so now we are finished with that round, and we move into the Overlord round. First thing that's going to happen is 4 enemies are going to be able to activate. Now, here's the thing. Yeah. Nobody can get past these two guys. Impossible. Not even with a shot. These two are completely defended by Rorden and Orloff. So all the hits and all the damage is going to be going into to these guys. So let us see. So I got 4 of them here. So 4 of them are going to be activating. The first one I'm going to activate is the Revenant, and he's going to attack Rorden. Rorden gets 5 dice, but since he's outnumbered, he'll get 4 dice. And the Revenant gets 4 dice as well. Rorden has an armor of 5, so the Revenant will have to roll 6s. Revenant did not roll any 6s, so no hits were incurred. That was our first model. The second model is going to be the Archer here. The Archer only has line of sight on Rorden, so the Archer is going to get 3 dice. Rorden is still 4, but the Archer has to roll 6s. It's not impossible, but that one did not score hit either. I'm going to go ahead and run this one. Unfortunately, I don't have any other way. I could bring him up in front. Oh, so he's not standing on a bone pile. One, two. And I'm going to attack Rorden Orloff because Rorden has such high armor. So that'll be 2 dice for the warrior. 5 dice for Rorden on his shield or on his defense. And he has an armor of 2, so he'll be ignoring 1s and 2s. Okay, he got a 6. This one's feeble, but I rolled a 6, so I blocked the 1 hit that came in. Thank goodness. Alright, so we know that this one is locked down. It can't go anywhere because we put Feet of Stone on him. So the only choice that he has is he's going to attack Rorden. So he is going to get 5 combat dice. Rorden is going to get only 4 because he's outnumbered. Now here's the kicker too. Rorden normally would have 5 armor, but this little forge breaker here treats all enemy armor as if it was 2 less than it would be. So his armor is now going to be a 3. So we're ignoring any 1s, 2s, and 3s on the hit from the... Oh, yes. That was finally a bad roll on their part. All of them were 1s, 2s, and 3s. So the hit from the king did not go through. All 4 have activated. And that means the only 2 left is we have 1, and he's going to raise a bone pile. And it's going to be behind Rorden because he can't... I think you have to be facing somebody with a free strike in order to get that. Or to get the free strike. So we're going to raise a bone pile here. I'm going to see what it is. We've got a 3, so that's going to be an archer. Ooh, right in the back. All right, so we have an archer here. And that finishes the overlord turn, so we're going to refresh these. I am making a mess here. Feet of stone gets refreshed only 90. So that's done there. The next overlord cards burn. 3 turns left, guys. Not looking good. All right, so rolling for or I don't have to roll for Orlok, but I have to roll for Rorden. 3, so nothing is healed. So now we go back to the fight. Okay, so this is gone. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to activate a feat. I'm going to activate Rorden's feat. And that is going to be None Shall Pass. Rorden cannot be injured for the remainder of this round. In addition, all adjacent enemy minions are considered to have taken their turn this round and may not move, may not have another for any reason. So the way I interpret that is no interrupts, no turns. This basically everybody that's adjacent to me, which is everybody but the ranger, cannot take their turn. But even the ranger, if he tries to hit me, he'll have to move and go elsewhere to actually get a shot off. Probably Orlov. So Rorden has taken his turn. We flip to see if we have an activation. We do have an interrupt with one model. That most likely will be the archer here. Knowing that we can't hurt Rorden, we're going to move him over. 1, 2. And fire at Orlov. So 3. Orlov gets 5. We have an armor of 2. So we'll see if we can see if that archer can get through. Alright, so we rolled a 6 and a 4 it was. And I rolled a 6 and a 4, and the 1 didn't make it through. So I was able to block the attack. So that finishes out this interrupt. And now we move back to the heroes. Man, what to do, what to do. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and activate the wizard. Bring him here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that a good spot to bring him in? Do I still have line of sight? I think I do. Okay, yeah, I should have line of sight. Alright, so we're now line of sight. I am going to corrode. I'm going to corrode Mr. King here. I am also going. I can't use Feet of Stone. I'm going to use Crystallize. Shield, I've already done. Steel Skin. Flame Bolt might be good. Burn is a major. What does he still have? I might use Brisk Work because I might have a something I want to try. All right, so first we're going to use Crystallize. Got a 4, so that's a power 2 energy crystal. That's really good to have. Okay. Then we got, I'm going to use Corrode. Don't need line of sight, short range, and so he is now Corrode. -1 armor. We'll then use Flame Bolt. With the two dice magical attacks, so 4 total, or the power 2 energy crystal. I'm sorry, Power two energy crystal with flame bolt. The attacking person is going to be the archer. And he gets two dice, and he has an armor of one. Okay, so we got a 5, a 4, and a 3. Got a 6 and a 3. So two of my hits came in. No. He's got an armor of 1, so 3 of my hits came in. So this one is gone off the board, no bone pile left. And then Brisk Work, I'm going to go ahead and cast that on. Let me see. Movement, normal movement rules apply. They may break away as normal. Shucks, I thought I was going to be able to do something. Okay, well, I'm going to do that anyway. I'm going to move here with Brisk. I'm going to move there with Brisk Work. That's going to give Skeleton. I wasn't breaking away, so I'm just moving. I'm still in his arc, so I don't think he gets a free strike. So that is how that is going to be. Since I'm still in his enemy, I'm just moving up one without sacrificing. Oh, wait. Or I'm not allowed to do that. I'm not allowed. I can't do that at all because I'm not allowed to move from the front arc of an enemy into the front arc of an enemy, the same one. So, yeah, I'm not going to be able to do that. He can't move because he's stuck. The Ranger. I'll move the Ranger. I'll do Brisk Work on Ranger. So we'll go 1-2. Not that that's really going to do anything, but. All right. That finishes Denor's turn out all the way. So we see if we have another interrupt. We do. We interrupt with one model. And they're going after the armored, which is going to be, it's going to be Rorden. Rorden's the armored. We have two choices for who's going to hit. And if it were me, I would definitely put Grund because he's got the harder hit. All right, so five dice. Yeah, now he's got five dice now. I get four for Rorden because I'm outnumbered. My armor is 3. So this might hurt. Come on. Oh, and it's going to hurt. Wow. So 3 6s, 2 5s. He couldn't roll that any better. I wasn't able to block. So I take one hit. And that finishes that interrupt out. Now we need to shuffle the deck here. Put you guys down for just a second. Deck. All right, so now we've done with that. We've had Orloff go. No, Orloff hasn't gone. Denor was the first one to go. Which we needed that. Oh, you know what? That attack did not happen. You know why? Because of Rorden's feet. I shouldn't have even rolled that. That attack should have never, ever happened. Okay. So, a little better. I just need to figure out. I need to figure out where I'm going now. Figure out what I'm doing. It's going to be good. We need to get the hits on the king here because I only got 3 turns to do it in. I'm going to go ahead and try to, with my archer, I'm going to try to take out this warrior here. So I know I get 5 dice, but since I'm shooting through the furniture around it and I'm not adjacent to it, I might as well, instead of doing that, I might as well go ahead and make myself adjacent to it by moving up one. So I don't have to get the negative on the dice. So 5 dice for the shoot two for the skeleton. It's as low as it can go because it's in the front arc of two enemies. So its armor is only going to be one. I don't think it's going to matter about, but I can re-roll these two for feeble. Okay, so both of them came in. So 5, 3, 3, 2, and 2. Rolled a 6, but 4 of my hits came in, so this one is gone. And that's going to finish the archer out. Next one is a non-interrupt. So we need to see who is left, who is going to go. I would probably say at this point, Orloff is going to go. Although it's going to leave my range, it's going to leave Orla or Denor exposed, but we really need to. Okay, Orloff is going. Orloff is going to attack with 5 dice. He's not outnumbered. The Grund is only going to get 4 dice because he is outnumbered. His armor is at a -1 for corrode, I want to say. So until the end of the round, so he's at an armor 3. So we'll see how this goes. I just need a hit on him. It looks like I was successful. So 5, 4, 3. This one is an armor of 3. So these 3 came. Looks like I got 3 hits. He wasn't able to block any of them. Now he does have the tough ability, but he doesn't have regenerate. So he takes a wound no matter what. And then we'll roll at the end of the round to see if he sheds that wound off or not. Okay, so now we see if we interrupt. We have 2 models that are going to be interrupting. And they're going after the marksman. Now there's nobody that can get to the marksman, so these two can't activate because of the ability Rorden put on them. So the only two that can go are these. So the first one I'm going to do is the archer. He's going to get 3. He's going after the wizard because that's the only target he can. Denor is going to get 2 dice. And he only has an armor of 1. He might be taking another hit. Yeah, he took another hit. Okay, so one more hit on Denor. And then this one is going to go ahead and raise up. Has no choice. That's going to be a skeleton warrior. And going to get a free strike from Denor. Or not Denor. Orloff. He's going to get only 4 dice because he's in the front arc of 2 enemies. The warrior is going to get 2 dice. And he has an armor of 2. So we'll see how this goes. Pretty well. Actually not well, but we're gonna reroll 2 of these for the frenzy ability. Ooh, much better. So 3 hits, didn't block any of them. He is dead. It's helping out a little bit. Okay, so that finishes that interrupt. Orloff is gone. Archer's gone. Denor's gone. Our last one is gonna be Rorden here. And he is going to, he's going to try to hit the Grund. I mean, we have no other choice here. So 2, what is he attacking with? He is outnumbered, so instead of 5, he would get 4. However, we're going to use a battle potion. So he's going to get 6 dice for the attack. Grund is in the front arc of 2 enemies, so he only gets 4 dice instead of 5. And his armor is also going to be a 3, so we ignore his 1s, 2s, and 3s. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Look at those 1s. I rolled 5 1s and a 6, which he blocked. That was a terrible roll. A waste of a battle potion, mind you. I think that's everything we can do. We now move into the Overlord turn. Let's see. These two can't activate because of Rorden's ability, so the only one that we can't activate is the archer. And the archer's going to take... this might be it, man. The archer's going to take a hit at... is going to take a hit at Denor. Man, I tell you what, last time I should have rolled my shield ability. I don't know why I did not. I totally forgot to do that. I'm going to go ahead and roll it now, which was two dice on my next defense roll. So my combat dice is a two, so I'll get a four total. The archer gets three dice, and he's hitting me. He's only ignoring ones. I think I was able to shed this wound off, thank goodness. Okay, good. So no wound there. That would have been the end of the game. Shield ability has been used. Everything is activated. So now we're going to roll for Grun's tough ability. He gets a one, so he's going to keep that. We'll roll for Rorden's tough ability. We got a four, so that stays. We burn our next Overlord card. And we're going to go ahead and refresh all these cards back up. And then we're going to continue on. I need to get Denor out of there. This is hurting him too much. All right. In order to get that guy, he could be in this space back here, right behind the archer. So we're going to do that. I'm going to move Denor 1, 2, so he is safe behind the archer, so he can't be targeted. And then we'll throw off some spells. Okay. See, what can I do to give my guys? Okay, so this one is done. I can cast Feet of Stone, I believe. Feet of Stone is a major. It's long, no line of sight needed. We will go ahead and cast Feet of Stone, so he can't move anywhere. He's attacking and defending at negative one dice. Okay, it is here. I can do another major spell. Not worried about anybody's health right now. So instead of a major, I could do two minors. Okay, I might do, instead of doing another major, since one major equals two minor spells, I may do that, see if I can. Or do I want to just, no, I definitely want a corrode for a minor spell. I want to put corrode on him, so he has negative one armor, see if we can really do some hits. And then, so we did Feet of Stone, which was a major. We did Corrode, which is a minor, so I could do one more minor. I will go ahead and take my chances, and I'll do Flame Bolt, which is another minor. And I will use, that's all I have left are Power Ones. Okay, so this will be a three dice attack on our ranger, which we're doing from here. It's a long flame bolt, does require line of sight, which I do have. The ranger is only going to get two dice, and he has an armor of one, so gosh, hopefully I can at least take him off the board. Okay, I can't. He rolled better. Okay, so 2-5, so that didn't do anything. So that finishes the wizard out, so we do not have an interrupt. I'm gonna move the archer 1, 2. and shoot at the archer here. So we're going to get five dice for this attack. Two for the archer. Ignoring ones. Rolling for a feeble. Okay, so five, two fours, twos. Everything got in, so this one's gone off the board. Let's see if we interrupt. We do not. So now our first attack that we're going to do is... let's see, what do we have here? Okay, so Orloff has used... Or Warden has used his None Shall Pass. He also has Angry. All enemy models adjacent to Warden must move away one square if there is room. If there is a choice, then Warden decides which square, and these models are not breaking away. No, I don't want to use that. Orloff's Unstoppable. No, I don't like that one either. Nobody has good stuff. So we're just going to do two attacks on our guy here. Okay, so first one, let's go ahead and use Rorden. See if we can help there. Rorden is going to get four dice. He's going to, because he's outnumbered, he's going to use his battle potion, which is going to give him two dice. Grund is outnumbered. Okay, so he normally would get five. He's outnumbered, so he gets four. He is corroded. Let's see. Feet of Stone is attacking and defending at negative one dice, so that takes away another dice. So he's corroded as well, which he has an armor of three, so hopefully something will be able to get through. Okay, this was Rorden attacking, so there's no rerolls. So we got a 6, a 5, a 5, and these are useless. So we got a 5 and a 4. So one hit came in. So that's all we needed to do was one. And that finishes out Rorden's turn. There is an interrupt with one model, and they're going for unarmored and the weakest. He has Feet of Stone, so he can't move anywhere. So either we're going to throw an attack in here, or let the Revenant do it, but it's probably going to be better for the Grun to do it, even though he's got the Feet of Stone mixed in there. So, all right, so let's go back to the calculations again. Combat dice, 5. He's outnumbered, so he's going to be attacking with 4 dice. He's got Feet of Stone, which means he's attacking and defending at negative 1 dice, so 3 dice. He'll hit. Who's going to be better to hit? The card is saying unarmored and weakest, those who've taken the most things. But we have a tie for Rorden and Orloff, so we'll just do a roll-off to see. Rorden is 1, 2, 3. Orloff's 4, 5, 6. Okay. So Orloff is going to be the target. Orloff's going to get 5 dice for the defense. And his armor is 1. His armor is only 1 because he's being hit with that Forge Breaker. Ouch. Okay, so 6, a 5, and a 2. Rolled a 6, 2 4s. So one of his five, one of the hits did come in. So we'll take that hit, and that's the only one that could activate. So now we're back to the turn, and Orloff is going to be taking the attack. So we're still 3 dice, and Orloff's going to get 5 for it, his hit. And then he's only armor 3, so we ignore 1s, 2s, and 3s. These two are feeble, so we reroll them. Doesn't really matter anyway. Got a 5, a 6. None of his dice were able to block the attack. So he took another wound. So he only has 2 wounds left to go. God, it's getting close, guys. That finishes the Overlord turn out. Oh, no, it doesn't. We haven't even done the Overlord turn. 2 cards. And we only have 2 models on the board. Some of this is completely irrelevant. Revenant's going to attack Rorden. It's locked into combat with him. Revenant gets four dice. And my dwarf gets four. And he is an armor. He's got to roll sixes. And he rolled six. He rolled a six, a single six, but I was able to block it. So that attack did not go through. Next is Grund. He's going to go ahead and probably attack Rorden because... No, he's not. He's going to attack Orloff because he has the less armor. All right, so three dice. Five for Orloff. And he's ignoring ones and twos. So five and a three. I did roll a six. Oh, okay. I rolled a six and a three, which beat out his five and three. So that's good. That's going to finish out both of these Overlord cards because there's nothing left to activate. So what we do now is end of the turn. Roll on Grun's tough ability. Two. Got nothing. Orloff's tough ability. Nope. And Rorden's tough ability. Nope. Okay, everybody's sticking with their wounds. Both of these go off. So those end of the round. This recharges up. Feet of Stone comes back up 90 degrees. So now we should be back in business. All right. It's going to be another Overlord card burn. So we have this turn and the end of the next turn. If we can't get it done by then, this game is over and we're out. So he needs two wounds and he's gone. So hopefully, let's see if we can accomplish that. All right, so the first one definitely is gonna be Wizard. What does he want to throw off? Corrode. Short, doesn't need line of sight, so we definitely want that one. He's got some feats here. Let's see. An orc can cast three different major spells. They may be even cast if they're currently recharging. An orc can cast a single spell at a greater distance than usual. Okay, he's going to use this one right here. He's going to use Focus because he's going to want to use Feet of Stone, which is currently recharging. Yes. All right, so he can do three majors. Three major spells. Let's see what I want to give him. Is burn, does not require line of sight, is short range. Short range is enough to get to the Revenant. So three majors. And if I can't find another major, because I don't have another major, then he'll just do two minors. Steel skin is a major. Are we hurting on anybody? I'm not really hurting on anybody. I could do two minors, then I could do Flame Bolt and Crystallize as my third major. So these are what I'm going to be using here. So Feet of Stones first. We're going to why am I doing that? Why am I not casting Corrode? Instead of Crystallize, I'm going to be casting Corrode as my second minor. All right, so Feet of Stone is going to go in here. Then Corrode is also going to go. So it'll be just like last time. It'll be just like it was last time. Okay. And Corrode, Burn, and Flame Bolt. We're going to use those. We're going to try to take down that Revenant. Because we can't shift these to anybody else. Now, Flame Bolt requires line of sight, so never mind on that. We will use Crystallize. Crystallize is a one. That's a power one. And it's not helping me too much. Now, Burn is a four dice magical attack. And I'll use a power one energy crystal. Make that a five dice. We're going to put that on the Revenant. And Revenant gets four dice. And what is he on? An armor of three. So we're ignoring threes. OK. Okay, so two feebles, a five and a four. He rolled a five and a four, of course. All right, so that attack did not do anything, and that finishes Denor's turn. So we do have an interrupt with one model, and they're going after the marksman. Neither of them can move. They're stuck in a combat. They wouldn't move because they would get a free strike. So the only thing that happens is they're either going to fight Orloff or Rorden. And at this point, I would probably say he's going to go after Orloff because he's got the lower of the armor. All right, so three again. Orloff gets five, and he ignores any ones and twos. Okay, so this one's gone. So a four and a three, but I rolled two sixes, so that one was definitely beat. All right, that finishes that one interrupt card. So now we move back again. We still have all three of our guys to go. The archer's not going to be able to do anything, unfortunately. There's nothing he can. He can't shoot the guy at all. So we'll start with Rorden. He's going to get four dice. And that's it, because he doesn't have a battle potion. And Grund is only going to get three. And he has got an armor of three. So we'll see if we can get just one hit. That's all we want, is one hit. Okay. Five, four, one and two. These are feeble. His six blocked my five, but nothing blocked my four. So yay. Another hit came in on him. And that's going to finish out Rorden's turn. We'll see if we have an interrupt. We do not. Now it's Orloff's turn. Orloff is going to get five dice. Grund is going to get three. We're going to roll. And it looks like we succeeded. Six dice, or two sixes, a five. He wasn't able to block any of that. So that means Grund has perished. Oh, wow. One stinking Overlord card left. One more wound on Denor. Look at that. That freaking beat the crap out of me. I cannot believe that I actually got through that. All right, so here is the aftermath. Well, this is the aftermath. Grund is dead. All right, so with reverence, Rorden removed the hammer from the corpse of the old king. Tears streamed down his craggy face. His shame was absolute. He had been forced to kill his own kin, his very blood, to put down the rabid revenant. Denor had tried to comfort him by explaining that it hadn't really been Grund that they had fought, but he had waved the young mage to silence. Humans just didn't appreciate the importance of certain things. Ah, Adventure 8. This is it. This is the big one. This is the next one that I will be playing in the final mission for the Dwarf King's Quest, Dungeon Saga. Only one gets out alive. Look at this. This is a nightmare. Woo! Oh, and look at this. 22 command cards. That's 19 turns that it's gonna, this is gonna be a long video series, I'll tell you that. It's insane, but okay, so hopefully you'll join me for my next video. We'll be doing the final adventure, Adventure 8, and a little preview maybe for those interested in sticking around and seeing what might be next. I kind of got that in the background there. I'll just kind of show you that. That's it. All right. So, yeah, like I said, enjoy me for my next video. We'll be getting this Adventure 8 set up, and hopefully it won't take 19 turns, but heck, this one, I only had one more left to get this done, but I was happy. We got it done, and the dungeon has been saved, I guess, if that's what you want to call it. But Mortibris, we're right out on his heels, that we should be right behind him and about to catch him next one. So appreciate you guys joining me for this episode or adventure, and hopefully you'll stick around. If you like what you see, subscribe to the channel, and you'll be up to date when the next one comes out, and you can watch it played. So appreciate it, guys. I hope you had fun, and I'll see you later.